Hi everybody, morning. It's very odd here. This is morning coffee, by the way. Slightly lying. It's not actually my first cup of coffee today, it's my second. This is my Abbey Road mug. Stephen Hattersley once told me that I was some kind of monster for having a black mug. But now is not the time for hatred, Stephen. So, back those ideas up, please. I am looking out my window. I can see the sea. We've had four or five of the most beautiful days weather we've had in about 6 months, and I've been inside. I've had some kind of cold. And just because of what's going on, and because I had a cough, I've had to stay at home for 7 days. But I'm feeling better today, which is good. There's actually scaffolding around our house. So I'm half expecting Tony the painter to become part of this video at any minute. But yeah, having a cup of coffee, enjoying the stillness. There's literally no traffic noise at all. I'm one block in from the seafront in St. Leonard's, just off Warrior Square. And the skies are blue. Even the seagulls are sort of respectfully quiet, which is weird. Maybe they've been affected as well. Anyway, morning. I meant to maybe be going back to school on Friday, but after the measures brought in by our leadership yesterday, I don't think anybody really knows what to do. So it might be quite nice to use this sort of early morning bit of quiet and calm just to think about something else, and I can strum some songs in the sun. And if there are any songs that you'd like to hear, mine or covers, genuine or hilarious, maybe I could do coronavirus themed songs. I could do My Corona by The Knack. I could do It's the Viral Countdown. I can't think of any else. If you can think of any other Corona themed songs that I could do that. But anyway, I thought I'd play this song because my voice is still a bit groggy. So for those who have seen me live in the last 3 or 4 years, you probably have heard this story, but this is a song I wrote in about 2015, it must have been. I wanted to propose to Sarah, but I know that I didn't have it in me. I'm a bit of a crier. I wanted to ask her to marry me, but I thought maybe a nice way of doing it would be to put it in a song. And I'd met with Sarah's dad, and after we'd sat awkwardly in a pub together for about 40 minutes, I've never asked him for a drink before. I should have, but I didn't. He said, Tom, you're either here for one of two reasons. Either you want money, or you're gonna ask me something else. And I eventually said, yeah, I'm gonna ask Sarah to marry me. He said, well, what's your plan? I said, we're gonna go to Paris for the weekend, and I'm gonna do it there. He said, brilliant. So we went to Paris, and my original idea was to propose to Sarah in the Orangery, the Musée d'Orsay gallery for the water lilies, which are, I think, my favourite paintings ever. Sarah loves them as well. But then I thought, well, if she says no, then I've ruined those paintings forever. So we didn't do it there. And then I always had this, I had this song in my back pocket. Because I thought if I propose publicly, then she might feel overwhelmed. The context for this also is that I'd said to Sarah about a month before, you know, do you think we should get married? And she said no. So this is what I'm working with here. So we went back to the hotel, and I got the guitar out, and I had the ring in the guitar case. And I had written down like bullet points of what I wanted to say. And I started singing this, I started playing the guitar, and she said, "What are you doing?" And I went green and completely bottled it. And so eventually, so the day went on, and meanwhile, Sarah's dad kept texting me saying, have you done it yet? And I said, no. And I just sort of kept ignoring the text. We went out for dinner, and I didn't want to do it in the restaurant. And then when we left the restaurant, I just couldn't find a good place to propose. It was Saturday night in Paris, so people were snogging and weeing and vomiting everywhere. And I kept walking around to try and find a good spot. And Sarah kept saying, you know, what are we doing? Why don't we just go back to the hotel? I'm so tired. And I was like, no, come on, Paris. We've got to make the most of this. And eventually it just got so late that I found a street corner somewhere and dropped to one knee, and she cried and I cried. I asked the question and she said no. And everyone thinks that bit's a joke, but it's not, quite understandably. And then we talked about it for a bit, and then she looked at the ring again. And then I said, you know, we can always get divorced one day. It's quite cool to be divorced. She said, oh yeah, it's quite cool to be divorced. So we kind of agreed on that. And and then she eventually said yes. I think it was like a maybe, but a yes. Anyway, so this was the song that I was meant to have sung. And it's a nice one for me to sing today because I'm still full of cold a little bit, although I'm feeling a lot better. But the first verse I remember I wrote, I was on the way, I don't know if they still follow me on any socials, but Chris and Pete Bokes, I was off to Southampton, I think it was somewhere on the South Coast, to write a song with them. It was part of the Write a Song with Tom Pledge Music things we used to do. And it was a really early start. I had to get there for 10, so I sort of left at sort of 9-ish, 8, I can't remember. I was driving down the motorway, I think past Brighton, and the mist was on the motorway, and I went into a tunnel, and I just thought, this is so beautiful. I kind of love being in the car really early with a big flask of coffee and music on. It's kind of one of my favorite places to be, actually. Sad sod that I am. And I remember I left myself a voicemail or something with these lyrics, but the lyrics are kind of, I guess they're about taking, the whole song's about taking stock, I guess, and being grateful for what you have. And maybe this is what morning coffee is about, you know. Maybe it's about, you know, deep breathing and looking out to sea. And even if you can't look out to sea like I can now, then look into the sea of your soul. Anyway, this is fairly low energy. I apologize. Anyway, this is called Sometimes. And oh, how beautiful the cars on the motorway. And how beautiful the mist in the trees. And oh, how beautiful the tunnels in the mountains. And how beautiful the falling leaves. But I'm a coward, and you know it. Always running from a fire. I've got coffee in the morning, I've got whiskey late at night. And though I spent life singing sad songs, it's only now I realize that sometimes it's just good to be alive. How beautiful the seasons blowing through an endless year. The leaves, the bud and flower, and then fall and disappear. And oh, how beautiful, my darling, that you and I are still here. I'll sing to you in a hotel room and whisper all my fears. But I'm a coward, and you know it. Always running from a fight. I've got coffee in the morning, and I've got whiskey late at night. And though I spend life singing sad songs, it's only now I realize sometimes it's just good to be alive. When I get nervous, I repeat myself, and when I'm tired, I just complain. Running from the storm, or hiding from the rain. And one of these days, I'm gonna prove to you what you mean to me. Maybe I'll go and buy a ring, maybe I'll get down on one knee. But I'm a coward, and you know it, always running from a fight. I've got coffee in the morning, and I've got whiskey late at night. And though I spend life singing sad songs, it's only now I realize that sometimes it's just good to be alive. And sometimes it's just good to be alive. I actually didn't even realize until I was singing it how perfect. I mean, if there's a series of videos called Morning Coffee, I've got coffee in the morning, I've got whiskey late at night. Maybe there needs to be a sister series called Whiskey Late at Night, where I just get progressively hammered and sing David Gray songs. I don't know why. It's funny, isn't it, the songs you sing with different friends. Sarah and I, whenever we're sort of playing cello and guitar and doing a bit of a sing-song, it's always either early Coldplay or David Gray. But then I've got my friend John Sterry, who, whenever we get drunk together, we play Libertine songs. Did you see the stylish kids in the riot? All that stuff. Anyway. Oh. I haven't sung in so long because of me cold / virus. Don't even know if I've got the virus. It's all a bit groggy early in the morning, but it's quite nice, this, isn't it? Quiet, gentle. Anyway, if you've got any requests, let me know. I quite like this. It's like a little morning routine. Such a beautiful day. Anyway, I hope you guys are okay. Stay safe. I would be over precautious if possible. I saw a video of a guy, I think from the World Health Organization, saying don't act in a way so that you don't get it. Act as if you already have it, so you prevent other people from getting it. Which is difficult because the loss of earnings that we're all staring down the barrel of as self-employed people is really pretty terrifying. And I don't even have any responsibilities really in terms of children or family or, you know, Sarah and I both work, so. But I have been trying to furiously save for this new album, which is half made, which is a bit of a bloody nightmare. But anyway, we can only do what we're going to do. Maybe the key is to sing more songs, drink more coffee, whiskey late at night. Stay on brand. All right, everybody. You're very sweet for watching all of this. Thank you. And let's chat. It's nice to chat, isn't it? I'm going to go and blow my nose. Lots of love.